How long you been fishing out here?
Forever. I'm 35, so ever since I can remember.
Yeah, and were you family of fishermen? Or?
Yeah, I am fifth generation.
Fifth generation fisherman. Are you from Reedville?
Yes.
Man, do you? Yeah, live.
I was born in Reedville.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you seen much change in town?
Yeah, a lot of change. A lot of people moving down. We're getting a lot of pressure on us at the Menhaden factory. You know, we just have a lot of people misinformed, and it's a propaganda.
Yeah.
It's a propaganda machine that in such a small community, we have so few people, we can't win, you know.
Menhaden have been called by some the most important fish in the bay or the most important fish in the sea. I've heard it referred to as a keystone species. The Bay Foundation frequently calls it a keystone species. And what that basically means is that it's a species or a critter that is fundamental to the bay's natural balance and ecology. The Menhaden is a little small, bony, oily fish that generally is not eaten by people unless you have a real peculiar taste. But it's not a fish that's harvested for human consumption. But other fish love it. And so it is a major part in the food chain for other fish, other predator fish, especially fish that we do like to catch and eat, rockfish, bluefish, trout. So it plays a major role in providing food for other fish out in the Chesapeake Bay. It's also a major food source for lots of birds of prey, bald eagles, ospreys, cormorants, heron. So it plays a vital role in the food chain for a lot of the birds that we care about too, pelicans and so forth.
Well, this current crisis that we're in actually started back in the 1980s when the governor of Maine allowed the Russian fleet to move into U.S. waters and purchase Menhaden from the purslane boats up in the Gulf of Maine. And this started the problem of overfishing the adult Menhaden spawning stock. At the same time that there was heavy reduction fishing going on off of the mouth of the Chesapeake Bay, off of Virginia and North Carolina, you had this intensive fishery there, along with the fishery it lasted for about 5 years from 1988 to I think 1993, and they pretty much fished out the spawning stock. At that point, the recruitment in the Chesapeake Bay collapsed. And we haven't had really good year classes of 8-0 Menhaden since 1994.
There is concern, and we share that concern at the Bay Foundation, that there may be the Menhaden population of the Bay may be being overfished. We don't have hard evidence at this point in April 2010 to firmly stake out that position. But there are certainly concerns that while the general population of Menhaden, according to the last studies done on the Atlantic coastline, the eastern seaboard, is generally healthy, the population that thrives in the bay may be being overfished.
We don't know how many menhaden are in the bay.
Did we ever know?
Nope. quite frankly, it's one of the more elusive things to estimate for local fish populations here in the Chesapeake. Menhaden are a schooling species. They form large, dense schools that aggregate near the surface of the waters, which basically means they don't lend themselves to being sampled or monitored effectively by the traditional ways in which we monitor fish population abundances. So for many years, they've been largely underrepresented, or efforts to monitor them and their abundance have not been high priority, so to speak, or haven't gotten off the ground.
it's a tough issue. It's a basic cornerstone as a species. It's a cornerstone of the bay's environment. It is a forage fish. It is a prime source of nutrition for large, economically important species, and recreationally very important species as well. Striped bass is a great example of that. And we have a very large recreational fishing community that targets striped bass. And they have a number of angler groups who have latched on to menhaden as being in decline and being of great impact and great importance to the striped bass fishery that they love so much. Is there scientific evidence to show that's the case? Not that I know of. Have we argued about whether or not there's scientific evidence to show that commercial fishing impacts the species in a serious negative way? Not that I know of. I don't know of any scientific study that shows that. I understand that the federal government is nearing the end of a stock assessment. The last stock assessment was a bay-wide, coast-wide stock assessment and showed that menhaden is not in trouble. It's not being overfished. Does that mean that they're in great shape in the bay itself? That's hard to say. Is it possible there could be some localized depletion in certain areas of the bay from commercial fishing? It is entirely possible. Is it enough to conclude that therefore it is having an adverse environmental impact? Not to my knowledge.
Target when these other groups are saying a Houston-based company, you know, yeah, the corporate office is in Houston, but, you know, it's run by the blood, sweat, and tears of people within 20 miles of here, you know, and I could take you to just about every one of them's home and show you that, you know, the kids out playing in the yard. It may be run from Houston, but, you know, it's from the people that have done this for 130 years in Reedville that's keeping this company in business.
Who has more of an impact? You know, that's kind of hard to say, actually. Who has more of an impact on the resource? You know, commercial watermen on a per capita man-by-man basis? Yeah, they impact the resources a lot more. But collectively, don't underestimate the impact of hundreds of thousands of people going out and flounder fishing. It's not insignificant.